This is my story of competing in the 1996 Olympic Games in Atlanta, sailing in the single-handed laser class. But this is a story that started over 20 years before that, sailing optimists at the age of 10 with my brother Theo at the National Yacht Club in Dunleary. We sailed all summer, every summer, and after winning the Irish Championships in 1975, I started sailing the laser, becoming junior champion at 18 and representing Ireland at the World Youth Championships. In 1992, I got a flavour for the Olympics by coaching my sister Denise at Barcelona, and shortly afterwards embarked on a full-time Olympic laser campaign, competing and training around the world, climbing the world rankings, so that just before the Games started in 1996, I was ranked 16th and ready for my biggest challenge yet.
The 1996 Savannah Olympic Regatta.
Sailing competition at the 1996 Olympics was in the Atlantic Ocean off the coast of Savannah, in mainly strong sea breezes with large waves and a beautifully warm water.
Walking round the room singing stormy weather.
Our sailing base was a specially constructed marina.
The city of Savannah made a big effort for Olympic sailing's own opening ceremony, the only one authorised outside the city of Atlanta. The stage was set by the riverside on historic River Street. It was a special night. Tens of thousands gathered to support the best sailors in the world as they marched in with their national teams. The famous Olympic torch relay made the final pass, and Savannah's Olympic cauldron was lit.
The laser is the ultimate one design class. All boats absolutely the same and provided by the Olympic organisation.
And here is the world champion and favoured for the gold medal, Robert Chait from Brazil. He was expected to be challenged all the way by Ben Ainslie from Great Britain. But with more competitors in the laser class than any other event in any sport at the 1996 Olympics, The competition was going to be fierce among the 56 competitors. Anybody feels the way I do about you now. Backbeat, the word is on the street that the fire in your heart is out. I'm sure you've heard it all before, but you never really had a doubt. I don't believe that anybody. So 11 races in the Laser, discarding your worst two results and getting a good start in the highly competitive fleet was essential to getting a good result. Most of the races were sailed in windy conditions where fitness was a premium. Steering the boat through the waves and working the boat hard was essential. Planing and surfing downwind was also order of the day, and missing a wave could cost you a place, no problem. This is my story of race 3. The race started in 10 knots of wind and an even bias on the starting line. I nailed the start at the committee boat end and was able to tack on the first shift. Stefan Warkala of Germany won the other end of the line, and we came together 3/4 of the way up the first beat, rounding the weather mark first and second, just ahead of a tight bunch headed by the Greek sailor. On the reach, I gained a boat length on the German and moved a little away from the pack. We headed down the run in marginally surfing conditions. And as we approached the leeward mark, I moved into the lead on the inside of the German, with the leading pack right behind, including world champion from Brazil, Robert Scheidt. I knew protecting the right side would pay, and at the end of a long windward leg, I'd extended my lead and knew I only had to run down to the leeward mark and a short reach to the finishing line. And there I am, crossing the finishing line in race 3, getting smoke. What an experience. As the regatta reached its climax, the gold and silver medals came down to Robert Scheidt of Brazil and Ben Ainslie of Great Britain. The penultimate race turns into a match race between the two, with Robert eventually winning out.
How many special people change? How many lives are living strange? Where were you while we were getting high? Slowly walking down the hall, faster than a cannonball. Where were you while we were getting high? Someday you will...
I started the final three races with an outside chance of a bronze medal, but it was not to be, and I finished the regatta with six top 10 places and one of only six sailors to win a race in the 56 boat fleet. In overall standings, finishing one place ahead of Francesco Bruni of Italy, the 1994 World and European Laser Champion, and two places ahead of Serge Katz, the twice Optimist World Champion.
Days of racing, 450 athletes, 10 classes, and 30 medals. Only 30 medals for all those people. But that's what makes the Olympics special. That's what makes the Olympics the ultimate sailing regatta.